Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve problems from IIT JAM 2020 Mathematics. So let us solve the problems. The first is, we have given a sequence xn is equal to 1 plus minus 1 raised to n divided by n, and we have given some options like xn is monotonic increasing or decreasing, or some option related to limit of xn. So I do not know the options exactly, but we will just analyze this sequence. So let us write the sequence. So xn is equal to 1 plus minus 1 raised to n by n. So this sequence is exactly equal to x1, x2, x3 and so on. Correct. So just write down the terms of this sequence. So x1 means when you put n equal to 1, it is 1 minus 1, it is 0. When you put n equal to 2, we will get it as 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. When you put n equal to 3, we will get 1 minus 1 by 3, which is 2 by 3. When you put n equal to 4, we will get 1 plus 1 by 4, which is 5 by 4. When you put n equal to 5, we will get 1 minus 1 by 5, which is 4 by 5, and so on. So the definition of monotonic increasing or decreasing sequence, we must have this x1 is less equal, x2 is less equal, x3 is less equal, x4 and so on. So in this case, the sequence is monotonic increasing sequence. And if we have the reverse case, that is x1 is greater equal, x2 is greater equal, x3 is greater equal and so on, x4. So in this case, the sequence is monotonically decreasing sequence. So let us see whether these conditions hold or not. So write down this x1 is equal to 0, which is clearly less than 3 by 2 because it is 0 and this is positive. So this is equal to our x2. Now let us write x3. So x3 is, if this is less than x3, then we can something say about this increasing or not. So x3 is equal to 2 by 3. But this is not true, because if it is true, then this implies 3 by 2 is less than 2 by 3, which is wrong, which is not true. So this option is not correct. So it is not monotonically increasing. Let us see this is true or not. But clearly our x1 is equal to 0, which is not greater than this 3 by 2, which is equal to x2. So this is also not correct. So it is not monotonically increasing or monotonically decreasing sequence. But here we can find out the limit of this sequence, because this sequence minus 1 raised to n is just equal to, when you put n equal to 1, it is minus 1. When you put n equal to 2, it is 1. Again, minus 1, 1, and so on. It is alternating sequence. So it is bounded. Alternating sequence consisting of 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1. So it is bounded by 1. This is the bounded sequence. Now, minus 1 raised to n divided by n, we can write this as minus 1 raised to n into 1 by n, the sequence 1 by n. And we know that if this sequence 1 by n converges to 0, and this sequence is bounded, and this converges to 0, so the limit of this sequence, that means this sequence converges to 0, because just write this result. Since if xn is bounded sequence and yn converges to 0, then this xn into yn converges to 0. But this is necessary, that it must be a bounded sequence. One of the sequences is bounded, and if other sequence converges to 0, then the multiplication of these two sequences converges to 0. So here minus 1 raised to n divided by n converges to 0 as n tends to infinity. So our original sequence xn is equal to 1 plus minus 1 raised to n divided by n will converge to 1 plus 0, because this whole sequence converges to 0. So this sequence converges to 1. So limit of this sequence, limit xn as n tends to infinity, is 1. Now let us solve another question. The question is, we have to find the limit of yn, where yn is defined by e raised to 1 minus xn, and where xn is n raised to 1 by n. So to find out the limit of yn, you just apply the rules of limit. So yn, you write down the definition of yn, which is e raised to 1 minus xn. So by the rules of limit, you just write it as e raised to limit as n tends to infinity of 1 minus xn, so which is same as e raised to, 1 is a constant sequence, so its limit is just 1, minus limit as n tends to infinity of xn. Now we have given a sequence xn, so we had to find out the limit of xn as n tends to infinity, then we are done. So to find out the limit of xn, we have xn is equal to n raised to 1 by n. So you just apply logarithm on both the sides, we will get log of xn is equal to, I'm taking this log to the base e, so this is log of n raised to 1 by n. So this gives us log of xn is equal to, this is 1 by n into log n, which is equal to log n upon n. Now you just find out the limit, you just take the limit on both the sides, so we will get this limit as n tends to infinity of log to the base e of xn is same as limit as n tends to infinity of log n divided by n. Now if n tends to infinity, then we know that this log n tends to infinity, so this is of the form infinity upon infinity, because as n tends to infinity, it tends to infinity, numerator tends to infinity and denominator also tends to infinity. So by L'Hospital's rule, this limit is just equal to, you take the derivative of numerator, which is 1 by n, and take the derivative of numerator, the denominator, which is 1. So this is just equal to 1 by n, right here, limit as n tends to infinity, limit n tends to infinity. Now as n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 1 upon infinity, which tends to 0. So left hand side is, you just interchange this log and limit, so we will get this as log to the base e of limit as n tends to infinity of xn, which is equal to 0. Now take take exponential on both the sides, so we will get this as limit of xn as n tends to infinity of, we are taking exponential, so it is e raised to 0. So therefore this limit as n tends to infinity of xn e raised to 0 is 1. So that is, this limit n tends to infinity of n raised to 1 by n is 1. Now just put this value of limit xn here, then we will get the limit of yn. So limit of yn, therefore this limit of yn as n tends to infinity is equal to e raised to 1 minus 1, which is e raised to 0, which is equal to 1. This is the answer. Now let us solve another question. The question is, we have given a 6x6 matrix, and 2 and minus 1 are the eigenvalues of the matrix M, and we have also given m raised to 5 is equal to ai plus bm, and we have to find out the values of a and b. So here the polynomial equation is m raised to 5 is equal to ai plus bm. So we can write this as just m raised to 5 minus bm minus a into I is equal to 0. So, and in the equation form, you can write this as say x raised to 5 minus bx minus a is equal to 0. So this matrix M satisfies the polynomial px is equal to x raised to 5 minus bx minus a, that is p of m is equal to 0, which is same as this m raised to 5 minus bm minus identity, a times identity is equal to 0, which is our equation. From the given equation, we have taken this equation m raised to 5 minus bm minus a times I equal to 0. That means a matrix M satisfies some polynomial, which is the polynomial px. So if lambda is eigenvalue of M, and if this matrix M satisfies some polynomial p of x, then this lambda also satisfies the polynomial p of x. That means p of lambda must be equal to 0. So here we have given two eigenvalues. So let us take lambda equal to 2 first. Then we must have p of lambda is equal to 0 by this result. So this gives us p of 2 is equal to 0. And that means when you put this value here, so 2 raised to 5 minus b into 2, which is 2b, minus a equal to 0. And when you put lambda equal to minus 1, we must have this p of minus 1 equal to 0. So this gives us 1 raised to 5 minus b into 1, which is just b, minus a is equal to 0. So we have these two equations. So these equations are just a plus 2b is equal to 32 and a plus b is equal to 1. So just solve these equations to get the, so just make it correct. This is minus 1 raised to 5, so it is minus 1, so this must be plus 1, so this is 33. So this gives us b is equal to 11. And when you put b is equal to 11 in this equation, so we will get this a is equal to 10. So these are the values of a and b. Now let us solve another question. We have given four curves, which are x square plus y square is equal to 2x, then x square plus y square equal to 4x, x equal to y and y equal to 0. And we have to find out the area bounded by these curves. So let us first draw the region. So here we have this x square plus y square 2x, so it will be minus 2x is equal to 0. And you can write this as x minus 1 the whole square plus y square is equal to 1. Now this is the equation of a circle with centered at 1, 0 and radius r1 is equal to 1. Similarly, x square plus y square is equal to 4x will give us this minus 4x is equal to 0, which implies x minus 2 the whole square plus y square is equal to 4, which is a circle centered at 2, 0 and with radius r2 is equal to 2 because it is 2 square. So just draw these two curves. So the first is, we have to find, it is a circle at center 1, 0 and radius is 1, correct? So this is the first. Now the second is, we have to find out, we have to draw a circle with center at 2, 0 and the radius is 2. So it is here, and just draw the circle. Right, now this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and y equal to 0 means just x-axis. So, and x is equal to y means this line passing through 0, 0. Correct. Now, all the curves are drawn. Now, let us find the region bounded by all these curves. So, let us just focus on this y equal to 0, that is x line, x axis, and x is equal to y. So, the region is must be this region, and the circles are x square plus y square is equal to 2x and x square plus y square is equal to 4x. So, this is the bounded region. Now, we have to find out the area bounded by this region. So, now here the curves are circles. So, the better way is we must convert the given equations in polar form. So, to find out the area, we have the formula area is equal to double integral over the region, say this region is R, 1 into dx dy. Now in the polar form, this dy dx will convert it into this R dr d theta, and this region have the limits as R and theta. But first, to find out the limits of R and theta, we must use this polar coordinate transformation, which is x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Right, so when you put x is equal to r cos theta in the first equation, we will get, also note that this x square plus y square will be just equal to r square. So from 1, we have r square is equal to 2 into x is r cos theta. So this gives us r will get cancelled with this. So r is equal to 2 cos theta. And when we put x equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta in the second equation, we will get r square is equal to 4 into r cos theta. Again, this r will get cancelled with this r, and we will get r is equal to 4 times cos theta. Now, the left side is this circle, inner circle, which has a radius 1. And for the limits of R, we have to take the left circle to the right circle, the outer circle. So, it is, for this, the limit of R is 2 cos theta and it is ending at 4 cos theta. So, R is varying from 2 cos theta to 4 cos theta. Similarly, you take the limits of theta. So theta is the angle. So theta is starting from this to this line. That means y equal to 0. So the angle with x axis is just 0. And here we have the line x is equal to y. So just put x is equal to y in the polar coordinates. So x is equal to y means what? R cos theta is equal to R sin theta. That means this R will get cancelled with this, and that is we have tan theta is equal to 1, and hence you apply tan inverse on both sides, we will get theta equal to tan inverse of 1, which is equal to pi by 4. So theta is varying from 0 to pi by 4, and just solve this equation, area is equal to this, so we will get this area is equal to integration. Now theta is varying from 0 to pi by 4. These are the constant limits of theta. Then r is varying from 2 cos theta to 4 cos theta. And r as it is dr d theta. Now just solve it. So integrate r with respect to dr from this theta is as it is from 0 to pi by 4. So it is r square by 2. And the limits are from 2 cos theta to 4 cos theta d theta. and this is equal to just 0 to pi by 4, 1 by 2, take it outside. R square is just 4 times cos square, 4 square cos square theta, minus the lower limit is 2 square cos square theta d theta, which is equal to 1 by 2 into 4 square is 16 minus 2 square is 4, that is 12 cos square theta d theta, integration from 0 to pi by 4, which is equal to, this is 6, integration from 0 to pi by 4 of cos square theta is just 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2 d theta, which is same as, cancel this, so it is 3 into the integration of 1 is, this is theta, cos theta is, integral of cos theta is sine 2 theta divided by 2, and the limits are 0 to pi by 4. So let us just put the values. So 3 outside, and this is when theta is equal to pi by 4 upper limit, plus this is sine of 2 times pi by 4, that is pi by 2, sine pi by 2 is 1 divided by 2, then minus the lower limit theta is 0 and sine 0 is again 0. So this is just equal to 3 into pi by 4 plus 1 by 2. So this is the answer. Now let us solve another question. The question is, we have to find out the surface area of, we are given the surface z is equal to 16 minus x square minus y square, and the region is the projection on xy plane. So when you take the projection of xy plane, we have z is equal to 0. So we will get this equation as 16 minus x square minus y square is 0 is equal to this. That means we get x square plus y square is equal to 16, which is just 4 square. Now this is just a circle. So when you put it in polar form, it will give us x equal to r cos theta. I am writing the equations again, sine theta. So we will get this x square plus y square is equal to 4 square, but this is just nothing but r square. So we will get r is equal to 4, because r is the radius, it is positive. So r is equal to 4. And because the lower limit for this is 0, so r is varying from 0 to 4. And on the circle, this theta is varying from 0 to 2 pi. So to find out the surface area, we have the direct equation, which is integral over this r, region r, into 1 ds, which is just equal to, write down the limits of x and y, plus del z by del x square plus del z by del y square into dx dy. So just put the values of these partial derivatives, we will get this as 1, plus when you take the partial derivative, it is the derivative of z with respect to x is 2x or minus 2x, its square is minus 2x square, which is just 4x square, plus same thing with respect to y, we have to differentiate it, so it is minus 2y, and the square of minus 2y is again 4y square dx dy. Now this was one of the option, maybe I do not know the options. This is over r, and when you take it in polar coordinates, we have this theta is varying from 0 to 2 pi, and r is varying from 0 to 4, square root of 1 plus this 4, you take common, it will be just 4 into x square plus y square, but we know that this x square plus y square is same as r square, and this dx dy is just r dr d theta. Now this was one of the option, we don't have to simplify it further, so just write it down. So this is from 0 to 2 pi, r is from 0 to 4, square root of 1 plus 4r square r dr d theta. So this is the option. This is the answer. Thank you.